Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video I'm gonna be sharing with you this look. This is another festive look makeup, and actually I wore this makeup on the day of Diwali. I know Diwali is over, so this is kind of get ready with me on Diwali kind of makeup. So you can carry this look during wedding season, which is around the corner, and this is very easy to do makeup and you can create this look in very few minutes. So if you want to know how I got this look, then please continue watching. So I'm gonna start my makeup with some skincare, and I'm applying this random face mask or sheet mask onto my face. Before applying this sheet mask, I kept this sheet mask into the fridge, which gave me calming and soothing effect onto my skin. And I kept this sheet mask for about 10 minutes onto my face. And after 10 minutes, I removed the sheet mask and gave a massage onto my face with the serum left onto my skin or face. Applying sheet mask before makeup gives you hydrating effect and keeps your skin very glowy. And when you apply makeup after a sheet mask thing, your makeup looks really very good and your skin actually feels healthy. Now I'm gonna blur out my pores using Maybelline Master Prime Primer, and I'm gonna press the primer onto my skin. The focus will be on my open pores basically. Now I'm gonna be prepping my lips, and for that I'm gonna be using Nykaa Serial Kisser Lip Balm. To get festive vibe, I'm gonna be applying W7 Beam Up Illuminator in the shade Dynamite. I will be going with a very little amount of this illuminator because it's very pigmented, and this illuminator provides very glowy effect which looks really very pretty. As you can see, I have first applied this illuminator onto the highest points of my face, and then I'm gonna be blending with my sponge to the whole face. I suggest you to apply this illuminator with your fingers or hands, because with that it really works well. For foundation, I'm gonna go with my new purchase, which is L'Oreal Infallible Foundation. I'm just gonna dot this foundation onto my face first and then gonna blend it with a beauty blender by Studio West. You guys know the drill, what kind of blending thing it is required, but I just suggest you to blend it very well. Just blend, because blending makes your makeup looks seamless and, you know, natural. So just blend it very well, and don't forget your neck because it's very important. And all the details of the products will be listed in the description box below, so make sure you check that. For concealing, I'm gonna be using Avon Concealer. I'm first gonna conceal my under eye area, followed by nose, forehead, chin and dark spots. Again, blending is a key when you apply concealer onto the under eye area, because it settles into the lines under your under eye, which doesn't look very nice. So just blend it very well. I'm also gonna conceal my pigmented area, which is near mouth, nose, etc. This is one of my favorite concealer because it's very creamy, provides good coverage, and I don't know whether it is available in India or not, but I'm gonna shortly search for a good dupe for this concealer and let you all know about it. Now I'm gonna take a banana powder from the Wet n Wild contour palette and set the areas where I tend to get crease and get fine lines. For eyeshadows, I'm gonna be using this Wet n Wild Rose in the Air eyeshadow palette, and I'm gonna be taking this transition shade and place that shade onto the crease area of my eye, and I'm slowly gonna build this color over there, and also I'm gonna intensify that color onto the outer corners or the outer V of my eye. Now I'm going to be using this pink shade and place that shade below the crease area of my eye, followed by the outer V, and I'm going to slowly build that color. And with a clean blending brush, I'm going to blend that color well. Now I'm going to be using this shimmery shade and place that shade onto the 1/3 of my eyelid area. Later on, I'm also going to use the brush to place that shimmery shade onto my eyelid area, and further I'm going to intensify the outer V using that pink shade. Now again, I'm going to be using this transition shade and place that shade onto the lower lash line of my eye. Later on with the pink shade, I'm going to blend that shade, transition shade, onto the lower lash line of my eye. Now I'm going to set my face with the compact powder. I'm going to be using Maybelline Super Fresh Compact Powder in the shade Pearl and set my whole face with that, followed by neck as well. And to contour my face, I'm going to be using Wet n Wild Contour Palette. I'm going to contour the hollows of my cheeks, jawline, forehead, temples, as well as nose. And to fill in my brows, I'm going to be using L.A. Colors Browie, Wowie Brow Pencil and fill in the gaps of my brows. For lower and upper waterline, I'm going to be using Maybelline Gigi Hadid eyeliner. And just forgive me for the scary face if you get scared of that. I'm also going to apply that shade onto the upper lash line of my eye. And I'm going to apply a very thin layer of that eyeliner. And I'm going to smudge that eyeliner with a slanted or angled brush. I was basically thinking to do a wing eyeliner, but later on I thought that if I get messed with that, so I just dropped that idea of doing a wing eyeliner and I went with the smudged eyeliner. Because when you are in hurry, you always tend to do mistake while doing wing eyeliner, so I thought of not taking any sort of risk at that moment. And to set my face, I'm gonna be using LA Colors setting spray. And to highlight my face, I'm gonna be using Wet n Wild highlighter in the shade Precious Petal, and I'm gonna apply onto the cheekbones, nose, forehead, brow bone, chin, etc., etc., basically all the highest points. And for blush, I'm going to be taking Nykaa K blush duo. I'm going to mix those two shades and apply that onto my cheeks. And for lips, I'm going to be using Sugar Smudge Me Not liquid lipstick in the shade Brink of Pink and apply that onto my lips. And here completes my final look. And wait, I actually forgot to apply mascara. I realized that later. So for mascara, I'm going to be using Wet n Wild Mega Length Mascara and apply decent coats of mascara onto my lashes, because lash applying mascara onto lashes makes a huge difference, and here completes my final look. And if you really like this look, then please give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel for more such videos. And I will see you all super soon in my next video. Till then, bye, take care, stay happy and spread happiness.